Hello guys and welcome to Computer Water once again. So today's video we're going to see today's daily challenge. So today's daily challenge is cities count using towers. So let us get into programming question. The problem must accept a matrix of size R cross C represents by R cross C. Okay, city. Each city may or may not have a cell phone tower. The presence of each tower indicated with the letter S. The presence of large tower is indicated with L. The absence of tower is represented by 0. Okay. Then the two types of tower with the signals. Nearer cities. Two nearer city across a tower which a city is installed. Okay. So guys, let us get into the sample input and output. So here is our sample input. So you need to print output in the form of single integer form. So how do we get output of 41 is, we got an R cross A matrix over here. Yes. Then if we found a letter called S, it means that we have only short tower. So only the range of the short tower is only the nearby cities. So we get nearby cities like that particular city it has mark. Then the nearby cities, which is a one city nearby. So we can get 9 cities for this single S tower. Then for this L tower, we can get nearby 2 cities like that particular city. And nearby 2 cities over right and left, over right and top and bottom. So if we count all the hashes in this particular matrix, the entire city, the entire count of the city with towers can be found. So guys, let us code for it. First let us get in R and C. First R and C is map of int of input of split, and we got R and C. After getting R and C, we can get list is input dot strip dot split for dash and range R. Then we need to assign a simple value for counting the towers. So let us use result. That should be simply we can say like simple we can fill a simple value called a string of 0 for dash and range R, which is an inner, it represents an inner list, and outside of the list we need to have an so guys, we have declared all our variables. So we can define a function called a fill city with which have OWR tower. We get an x and y axis, then also a value. So the value might be 1 or 2, which 1 represents then it is an shorter tower, then L represents it is a longest tower. So we can pass through a iterate to a for loop for I in range. X minus value, then Y plus value plus 1. So if I found that where I range is not in my matrix indexes, so I need to skip that. So what can I do is, where I is greater than or equal to 0, and also I should be lesser than C R, where is the row. So I can iterate to an inner matrix for I in range. chain range y minus value, then y plus value plus 1. Yes, then that is also the case where I need to iterate only through the j row, where within the range j row and j is c, so that can be res of I j equal to hash, so going to fill with hash. That's it guys. Then we need to iterate through our list. If let's say like if we found a letter called S in list of I, or L in list of I, so that's how we find. So we can skip some iteration where we haven't need to pass through this or this or even this and also this rows. So we can skip this with using this if condition. If list of I j equal to yes, you can fill city with tower using I j and value called 1, or else if first the list of I j have the largest tower, then we can fill city with tower of 1 j and 2. Then we can simply assign a temp variable called count. Then for I can get a temp and result. Count plus equal to temp list of count of asterisk. So finally we can print our count. Let us try to execute this program. Let me copy and paste this sample input. So yes, we got an output of 41. So that's it guys. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to Computer Coder. Until then, bye.